Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So I'm back with the video for you guys, and this video, you all know, is going to be very beneficial for your phase 1 of RBI grade B, SEBI grade A, NABARD grade. So those who are preparing for these exams should watch the Morning Tale series regularly. Apart from those people, guys, this video is also useful if you are preparing for any kind of banking examination at the level of PO. So on that note, the students who are coming for the first time, please guys subscribe and hit the bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where we share free quizzes as well as resolve your queries. So if you have any query related to your career or your any exam, then you can ask us on this channel. And the link of it is in description below. So here we are on the first question, which is about an index released by Economist Intelligence Unit. So guys, this index is about the health, personalized health. And we all know how much health is important in the current scenario when the entire world is struggling with the COVID-19 pandemic. Therefore, such kind of indices that are related to healthcare have assumed a greater significance from your exam point of view. Therefore, you are required to listen to me very carefully in this question. Okay, but that doesn't mean that you would not listen to me carefully in the other questions. You have to pay attention to what I'm saying equally. But you have to memorize the facts that I'm telling you in the questions more, I would say more thoroughly. Okay, so now let's discuss this question. What is India's rank in the Economist Intelligence Unit's Asia Pacific Personalized Health Index? So we have 121st, 10th, 51st, 63rd and 77th in the options. What is the right ranking of India in this index? So the right rank is 10th. Wow, right? You would be thinking that it is such a great rank that India has achieved. But let me shatter your hopes here. It is not so. India's ranking is 10th, but that does not mean that India has performed exceptionally well in this index, because the total number of countries that were assessed in this index were 11. So out of these 11 countries, India is 10th. So in other words, we can say that India is the second last country in this ranking. Now this indicates how poorly India has performed in terms of health, personalized health. Now guys, we have talked about the total number of countries. We know the organization releasing this index. We also know what is India's rank. Now, which country has topped this ranking? So the right answer is Singapore. Singapore has topped this ranking. Now, this ranking has 27 indicators on which the countries were assessed, and these 27 indicators were clubbed into 4 categories. Now, these 4 categories are collectively called vital signs. So, the vital signs are spelled as this. So, these are the vital signs. Now, which parameters, what are the names of those vital signs? Let's find that out along with the India's ranking on each parameter. So this is the table, and these are the 4 vital signs, 4 categories on which different countries were assessed. And in these 4 categories, 27 parameters have been clubbed. This is the thing that you have to memorize. Okay, so policy context, in this parameter the ranking is 5th. Then health information, the ranking is 10th. Personalized technologies, 9th. Health services, 11th. So these are the rankings of India, and you have to remember these rankings. Okay. Now we are on our second question. Who has been named as the MD and CEO of SBI Card? So guys, if you remember that some days back we discussed the SBI MD. Recently a person has been appointed as the MD of SBI, and that person was the recent MD and CEO of SBI Card, who resigned from this designation to be the MD of SBI. Now guys, your task is to name that that person. You have to name the person in the comment section below. And now let's find out who is the person that has filled that person's shoes. So we have Nivedita Shukla Varma, V.L. Kantha Rao, Vishal Gagan, Rama Mohan Rao Amara and Naveen Kumar Jain in the options. Out of these options, the right answer is option D, Rama Mohan Rao Amara. So he is the MD and CEO of SBI Card. Next question is, whose debut book is titled Yearbook? So this is again a very interesting question. So you have to remember such kind of books that are provided in Spotlight magazine in the miscellaneous section. We have five options right in front of you. Option A is Seth Rogen. Option B is Mel Gibson. Option C is Ryan Reynolds. Option D is Matthew McConaughey. And option E is Keanu Reeves. What is the right answer? The right answer is option A, Seth Rogen. And remember, he is a Hollywood actor and writer. In fact, all the options mentioned in the question are actors of Hollywood. Okay, so this question is important. You are required to listen to me very carefully. What is the GDP growth rate for 2020 to 2021 as per FICCI's Economic Outlook Survey? So FICCI is our indigenous industry body and it has released this Economic Outlook Survey, therefore it is very important. Now you have five GDP forecasts for the 2020 to 2021 year. We have 9.6%, 9.9%, 7.4%, 8% and 5.5%. Which one is the right answer? The right answer is option D. -8% is the GDP forecast for 2020 to 2021. For 2021 to 2022, 9.6% is the GDP forecast. Now we have talked about the GDP forecast. We should also look at the government's fiscal deficit. So how much is the targeted fiscal deficit, or we should say projected fiscal deficit in this report? So it is 7.4%. And how much is it greater than the budgeted target? The budgeted target was 3.5%. So you can see the difference yourself. The target that the government decided was 3.5%, and due to the COVID pandemic, it is projected to rise to 7.4%. So that's all for this question. Now I would expect you guys to answer me, who is the chief of FICCI? So this is your question for the day. Okay guys, now in this table you can see that three sectors are given: agriculture, allied services, industry and services. So FICCI Economic Outlook Survey presents the GDP growth rates for 2020 to 2021, the growth rate of these three sectors basically. So from the table you can see that agriculture is the only sector which is showing positive growth rate of 3.5%. Then we have the industry sector which is showing the highest contraction at -10%. Services is showing -9.2%. So guys, this is for your reference only. This was I provided this table so that you can be informed about the different forecasts given for different sectors of India. So I hope that it is clear to you now. Okay, so we are again going to discuss another index which is related to the health sector. Now, the question is, what is India's rank in the COVID-19 performance index of Lowy Institute? So first of all, where is this institute located? It is a very prestigious institute and it releases important reports. And this institute is located in Australia. It is an Australian think tank. Remember that. Can you guys name a very important Australian organization that releases the military expenditure report of different countries? So this is very common, guys. I have provided you this this report many times in the Spotlight magazine. So now it is your task to tell me that what is the name of that organization that releases the military expenditure report every year. Now let's come back to this question. So we have India's ranking. We have five options. Option A is 86. Option B is 91. Option C is 104. Option D is 51. Or option E is 67. Which one is the right answer? The right answer is option A, 86. And the total number of countries that were assessed in this index was 98. So out of 98 countries, 86th is India's rank. Which country has performed best in this index? It is New Zealand. And which country is at the bottom? It is Brazil at the 98th rank. You would be amazed to know, some of you would be amazed to know this thing, that US has also fared very worst in this index because its ranking is 94th. So the world's superpower has not even performed well in this COVID-19 performance index. Now guys, we have discussed the organization total top, the India's rank, the bottom country. Now, what is the thing that we are missing here? Parameters. So we have six parameters in this index and I am going to write all those parameters for you guys. So the first parameter is cases, second is confirmed death, third is cases per million population, then we have deaths per million, then fifth is test as a proportion of cases, and test per 1,000 population. So these are the six parameters on which 98 countries were assessed, and India ranks at 86th position in this index. So guys, that's all for this index. Now we are moving on to our last question of the day. So who has topped the brand finance list of brand guardianship index 2021? So basically this brand guardianship index is the list of top CEOs of the world. So we have Jeff Bezos, option A. Option B is Satya Nadella. Option C is Shantanu Narayan. Option D is Jensen Huang. And option E, Ajay Banga. So out of these five options, the right answer is Ajay Banga, who is the CEO of MasterCard. So guys, in this 2021 list of various rankings, Brand Finance has released four indices, or we can say four rankings. So the first ranking is Brand Finance IT Services 25-2021 report. In this ranking, top 25 information technology companies were assessed. Top countries Accenture, and India, from India, Tata Consultancy Service is at the third position. World's strongest brand, top is WeChat, which is a Chinese app. Fifth is Reliance Jio. So this is an important ranking. Do remember this ranking. World's most valued brand, we have Apple at the top. Tata Group is at the 77th rank. Best CEO, as we discussed, Ajay Banga, the CEO of Tata Group. Sorry, Ajay Banga, the CEO of MasterCard, and TCS CEO Rajesh Gopinath is at the 5th ranking, and Mukesh Ambani is at the 6th rank. So that's all guys. I hope that you have enjoyed this session, and if you have, then do share it with your friends. And also, do not forget to watch the budget session that was taken by Manish sir yesterday only, because budget is important for your phase 1 as well as phase 2 exam. So watch that session, and if you have enjoyed this session, then do spread it with your friends. Thank you so much for watching this session.